Hey folks, Michael James with HDRIblog.com and on Twitter, HDR Photography. I'm going to do a quick video showing you how I deal with a bedroom, in this case, that has its own bathroom. In a lot of cases, in these small condos and these small places that I have to shoot at, you end up with an entranceway that's like this, where you have a very narrow passageway before you'd be able to get in here and take a shot of the bathroom itself. So for me, obviously a solution is not to shoot from outside here, because even getting the lens just inside this door frame is going to end up where you're going to have the left and the right hand side clipping off the actual room. The only way to take this shot is to get the camera itself inside the doorway. So once you put it inside the doorway, clearly you're going to have an issue now, because now you have to deal with the situation of it needs to be photoshopped out. So how do you get around that? How do you deal with this and not have to clone forever and forever? Because it is kind of a pain in the butt to clone. Well, the easiest way is to just take a shot of what's behind you and then mask it out. And I'll just explain to you what I've used as a workaround. I have no idea what everyone else is doing, but I'll take my typical brackets here with everything in place. Then what I'll do is, notice the door frame itself right now. What's going to have to happen is you're going to have to mask out the door frame. And then we're going to turn the camera around and take a shot of the bedroom itself that has that picture up there, the window behind me, and you can see there's a little bit of bed off to the side here. Now, I'm going to try and hold this camera here, and I'm going to show you what I usually do. I usually kill the lights of the room behind me, and then that helps to be able to try and mask out later around the door frame, because it gets black and then it's a lot easier. You can actually use luminosity as a way to knock that out. And you know, I cover all that stuff in the training, but this is one of the workflows that I use. So I'm going to come back, turn this back on just to show you what I do after I've taken that. So I'd already done the bracket. I already turned the lights off and then took extra shots with the lights off so that I'd be able to more easily mask that out. And then I need to make sure I frame this up. I would look on the back of the LCD itself to figure out exactly how much of the room I need to shoot, but it's going to be roughly about this much. So I turn the camera around and make sure I have full coverage of the area that's going to have to be photoshopped in with the masking. And then I would take this extra shot, which is roughly what I'm showing you right now, and then that would be what has to be brought into Photoshop as a separate layer, and then I would be able to mask out of the layer that has the shots with the camera in the way. And then once you've done that masking out, the camera disappears and you end up with a full shot. So you end up with what ends up being this full shot of the bathroom. And after I've processed this, I'll show you the final results. But after I've done that, then the camera itself, I guess I'll have to try and move to show you how the camera is in fact in the way. Now, one of the things I always try and do is I try and make sure I take the camera away from the door frames. So even though the best shot might have been just another half a foot maybe to the right, then you end up with the camera being in the way of the door frame and you'd have to clone this out. Now, I do that if it happens to be such an amazing angle just going an extra half a foot that way. But in most cases, I sacrifice the shot slightly to move it off the door frame so you don't have to do that extra cloning here. And all you have to do is take the shot of what's behind you and mask that in. It's a much faster workflow. That's it. Michael James, HDRIblog.com, and on Twitter, HDR Photography.